New allegations, even more allegations about shocking behavior from former CBS boss Les Moonves and the climate, the culture at his former network. Claims of abuse and a cover-up now reported by the New York Times, which obtained a draft of a law firm's report that is due to be delivered to the CBS board very soon. Hanging in the balance here is a huge amount of money, $120 million that Moonves was owed according to the terms of his contract. But if the board can conclude that he was fired for cause, they won't have to pay him that money. And that's why this law firm report is so important. But it's important for another reason. We need to know what happened at CBS. We need to know what went wrong and why it was able to be kept secret for so long. So let's get into that now with my next guest. She is one of the women who has accused Moonves of sexual assault and harassment. Her allegation dates back to the 1980s. Moonves, of course, denies it. He's denied all of it. He says he's never engaged in any non-consensual sexual relationships. But Phyllis Golden-Gottlieb strongly denies that.
Yes.
She says it happened to her repeatedly. She's joining me now from Los Angeles, along with Gloria Allred. Phyllis, thank you so much for coming on the program. I know you'd rather not be here. You say that your career was ruined by Les Moonves and what he did. Tell me how he was able to get away with this.
Because they can get away with this, that's why. And it's the same thing when I found out that I wasn't getting the same amount of money as the men in my, as a vice president. I mean, there was no one that we could go to, which is why it took me so long to really go to the police, because
And when you did go to the police, they said the statute of limitations had run out. But now at least, I'm glad CBS hired these law firms to apparently investigate what happened. You spoke with the investigators, right? What was that experience like?
Yes. No, that I thought that was fine. I thought they asked the right questions, and I don't know how they're going to put it together, but I thought that it was fair.
It was fair. And Gloria, you've been representing several other women who had other encounters with Moonves. Can you tell us how many women, and have they also spoken with the law firm?
Yes, Brian, I do represent four women who wished to speak to the investigators, to the law firm that the CBS board has hired to do a report to the board about Mr. Moonves and whether or not he engaged in any sexually inappropriate conduct with them. I know there are rumors that the report might come out this week, but I can tell you that as to the fourth woman that I represent, we are meeting with the investigators for the first time on Tuesday in New York. But I will agree with Phyllis that as to the other three that they have interviewed, and I have been present during those interviews, I do feel that the investigators were being very fair, very professional, and very sensitive to the women who allege that they are victims of Mr. Moonves.
Yes.
That's good to hear. Look, I mean, CBS, there's a lot of great people that work at CBS. They deserve a better corporate culture. They deserve to know what really happened, and they deserve to see proper outcomes here. One of the questions is about that $120 million. Is it really conceivable that Moonves could still be paid that amount of money now that the New York Times says the law firm found evidence that he destroyed evidence of text messages that were incriminating, that he tried to cover it up? I mean, they can't possibly pay him the money, right, Gloria?
Well, it really depends on the terms of his contract. And is he going to be fired for cause? Is he not going to be fired for cause? We don't know whether it's true that, in fact, he destroyed evidence that, in fact, would be very serious. And I'm sure that if Mr. Moonves has not been honest with his employer, CBS, CBS is going to be, and this is putting it mildly, very upset with him.
And,
that's right. Or if he's hidden evidence, if he hasn't been truthful, if he's misled. But we don't know whether that, in fact, is true. But this is all about Mr. Moonves, the discussion. And my concern is those who allege that they are victims, those who've had the courage to come forward at no, they've sacrificed a lot. They are taking legal risks. They are doing it because they want CBS to have the full report. I hope that this report will be made public, but I also hope that CBS will do more than perhaps just donate millions of dollars to organizations. they need to be accountable to the persons who can prove that they are victims. If they can prove it, they need to compensate the victims, because they should not just be a footnote in all of this. It's about rewarding those who have had the courage to come forward and who've had to live with what they say was complete misconduct and taking advantage of them when they were with Mr. Moonves.
And this is behavior over the course of decades. Sorry, Phyllis, to interrupt, but what you allege happened was in the 80s. Other allegations are from the 90s and from the early 2000s. And then, of course, Moonves ran CBS for 20 years, from the mid-90s all the way up until this September. So this is something that spans decades. I wonder for you, yes, Phyllis, the idea, the possibility of him being paid so much money, so much severance, how does that sit with you?
Well, you know, if I think about it, it would really get me upset about it. But my feeling about this was I just wanted him to be miserable. I didn't care about the money.
Interesting.
He did ruin my career. And, you know, you work hard at that. And especially in those days where there were fewer women. And when I would not go along with his games, then he moved my office down into like the cellar and made it very clear that I couldn't stay there.
So your office got smaller and smaller, right? When you rejected him,
right,
at one point a violent advance that you allege, the office got smaller and smaller, and basically your career was squeezed away.
Exactly. And, you know, I recall when he picked me up and threw me against the wall, I said to my secretary, "Did you see that? Did you hear it?" "No," she said, "no." I thought, well, she's smart. You know, she doesn't want to get involved.
And Brian, regardless of the statute of limitations, this arbitrary time period set by law, it's never too late to do the right thing. So that the corporation, CBS, can do the right thing, and they don't need to stand on technicalities. And they are interviewing and interested in interviewing women who allege they were victims even before Mr. Moonves came to CBS. So the time period now in which the report is going to have to be done and turned over is getting shorter and shorter. So I would urge anyone who alleges that she has information about Mr. Moonves, positive or negative, about sexual harassment conduct, if that occurred, to right now contact CBS and let's have a full and transparent report.
That's a good idea. That's
can't argue with that. Gloria, Phyllis, thank you so much for being here. A couple notes on the way out on this. It's not just about Moonves. The law firms are also looking into the allegations against Charlie Rose, Jeff Fager, and others. According to the New York Times, there's an allegation that the former 60 Minutes producer Don Hewitt was engaged in harassment, and CBS had to pay off an accuser for many, many years, more than $5 million over time. So there's a lot here, and hopefully more information will come out later this week, because the CBS board is having its annual meeting on Tuesday. More to come on this. Of course, Moonves denies the allegations. He denies ever engaging in a cover-up. He denies any non-consensual sex. But as you hear, there are many women, more than a dozen women, who say otherwise.